This video is going to be about the commutative, associative, and distributive properties. Basically, these things are common sense, and you probably know them already. Probably the only hard part is remembering the names for them. So let's start with the commutative property. The commutative property says that if you have two numbers, let's say 5 and 10, you can add them in two different ways. You can either say 5 plus 10, or you can say 10 plus 5. Kind of makes sense. The same thing will work for variables. So if you have x plus y, that will be the same as y plus x. So why is it called commutative? Well, when things commute, when people commute, like if they commute to work, they move, they change places. And what we're doing is we're taking these numbers, the 5 and the 10, for instance, or the x and the y, and we're changing their places. So this is the commutative property of addition, because we're dealing with addition. We've also got a commutative property of multiplication. And all that says is if we have two numbers, let's use 5 and 10 again, we can say 5 times 10, or we can say 10 times 5, and we'll get the same result either way. And if we have variables, we can say x times y, or we can say y times x. Once again, all that's happening is the numbers or the variables are moving. They're changing places, and so they're commuting. And this becomes the commutative property. Okay, so we have the commutative property of addition and the commutative property of multiplication. Let's go on to the associative property. So let's say we have three numbers. I don't know, let's say we have 2 and 3 and 4. We want to add them. Well, we could either add the 2 and the 3 together first, and then add the 4, or we could take those same three numbers, 2, 3, and 4. We could add the 2 to the sum of the 3 and the 4, and we're going to get the same result either way. When things associate, when you have an association of people, you have groups of people. So this is the associative property of addition. Once again, it'll also work for variables. So I can have x plus y in parentheses plus z, and that would be the same as x plus, and then my parentheses, y plus z. You realize it's pretty obvious these things are equal. Okay, and that's the associative property of addition. Associative because these things are forming associations. They're forming little groups. We also have an associative property of multiplication. And all that says is if I have 2, 3, and 4, and I want to multiply them, I could multiply the 2 times the 3 first, and then multiply that result by 4. Or I could take my 2, 3, and 4 and multiply the 2 times the product of the 3 and the 4. Once again, these things will be exactly the same. And once again, we can do the same thing with variables. So I can have x times y times z, and I could multiply the x and the y first, and then multiply the product times z. Or I could have x and y and z and multiply the x by the product of the y and the z. So this is the associative property of multiplication. Once again, I think this is common sense. You probably knew it already. So the last property is called the distributive property of multiplication over addition, which is a great name. Here's all it means. Let's say I've got 2, and I want to multiply that by 3 plus 4. Okay, well, what the distributive property tells me is that I can distribute this multiplication, the 2 times something, to whatever is in the parentheses. So I'm going to distribute the 2 times to the 3 and distribute it to the 4 2 times 3, let's just write that as 2 times 3. I'll take my plus sign, and then 2 times 4. Carrying out this multiplication, I'm going to get 2 times 3 is 6, plus 2 times 4 is 8, and that's going to equal 14. The other way I could have done this, the way you might have been thinking, is I could take 2 times 3 plus 4, add the 3 and the 4 together. In other words, turn this into 2 times 3 plus 4 is 7, and 2 times 7 is 14. Either way, I get the same answer. So the distributive property of multiplication over addition says that if I'm multiplying a number or a variable times the sum of numbers or variables, that's what's in this parentheses here, what I can do is multiply that number times each of the parts of that sum separately. And I could have more than two parts here. So in other words, I could have something like 3 times, let's say 4, let's put a minus sign, minus, let's use a variable, 2x plus, I don't know, 5y. And to distribute this multiplication, what I'm going to do is take the 3 times the 4, and that's going to give me 3 times 4 is 12. I'll take the 3 times the negative 2x, so I'll have negative 6x, 3 times the 5y, so that will give me a positive 3 times 5 is 15. Okay, and the result I get from distributing this 3 over this 4 minus 2x plus 5y is going to be this, 12 minus 6x plus 15y. And that's it for those properties. Take care. I'll see you next time.